From the outset of World War II, Germany demonstrated ruthless tactical superiority and engineering excellence in its tank warfare. The Nazis created an armored force to which the Allies had no answer, and made it their business to stay one step ahead. In 1943, German tank technology found its ultimate expression in the Panther, 8th greatest ever tank. This is the last remaining operational Panther in the world, and the greatest ever brought this Panther veteran face to face with the big cat he commanded over 60 years ago.
This thing is from outside in perfect shape. It couldn't be any better. You know, I could hear it and smell it again, you know. That's exciting. Very exciting.
The Panther was a big shock for the U.S. Army and for the British Army. It's an upsurge or evolution in tank design compared to everything that had preceded it. The single most important feature on the Panther was its firepower. It had a superb gun. The long 75mm gun that the Panther introduced was probably the best all-around tank gun of World War II.
Okay, move!
The Panther gun was purpose-designed as an anti-tank weapon. It achieved its power not by going to a larger caliber, but by going to a longer barrel and a larger powder charge.
The gun itself, it's a very long barrel, and the size of the barrel is important because the longer the shot is in the barrel, the higher the speed, the higher the muzzle velocity.
Like every other Panther commander, Wolfgang Stirner was impressed by the awesome power of the gun.
You can destroy with this tank an enemy tank broadside at 2,000 meters without any problem. Any tank.
The Panther's original design came as a result of Germany's experiences on the Eastern Front. In 1941, German tank tactics fell apart when they encountered a new breed of Russian tank, which they were horrified to discover was much better than their own. Shamelessly, the German response to their new foe was to copy it, and the first thing they nicked was its sloping armor.
This type of tank is the first tank we had in Germany with a sloped armor. This armor has a size of about 80 millimeters, but due to the slope, it has a protection ability of 100 millimeters, because if you get a front hit, it bounces off.
Not satisfied to merely copy the Soviet tank, the Panther design aimed to improve on it.
As we look at the front of the tank, you may notice this rough appearance. This is not shoddy workmanship. What this is a pretty sophisticated piece of countermine technology. It was a paste that was troweled on, purposely troweled rough. It was then hardened with a blowtorch, and its purpose was to provide standoff from magnetically attached mines.
The improvements didn't stop with the armor. The Germans took pride in giving the tank a complete engineering makeover.
Whereas a mechanism in a Russian tank might weigh 100 pounds to do a particular job, the Germans could take that 100 pounds and get it down to maybe 70 pounds.
Here you have the casting for the engine block for the Panther. And as you can see here from looking at it, this is an incredibly intricate casting. It's got lots of thin sections. It's been very carefully engineered so that I would say a comparable Russian or American unit to this would be heavier and larger. It might be somewhat more rugged, but this is designed so it's right there on the edge.
So the command comes now, Panzer March! Go!
The complicated Panther saw its first action at the Battle of Kursk, the biggest and meanest tank battle of World War II. But from the off, things started to go wrong.
Most tanks broke down before seeing any action. They were not ready for combat. They were much too early to be brought to the front. It was not a very impressive situation at first.
The problem with the complex engineering was not only that it was prone to failure, it also wasted precious time and resources.
These are the main bearings for the Maybach V-12 engine that powered the Panther. They're a beautiful piece of engineering. They're designed to last for years. The problem was the Panther lasted weeks or months in combat, and it's one of the reasons that the Germans lost the war. They just couldn't back off from engineering excellence in every aspect of their weapons.
The German national character seeks too greatly after perfection, when perfection is not only not needed, but it's counterproductive.
It's said that if Germany hadn't gone overboard with the engineering and built simpler tanks in larger numbers, the war could have had a different result. Still 1-0, but to the other side. So, whichever way you look at it, this tank rightly deserves its ranking at number 8. Legendary Panther is a machine that if it didn't exist, we'd have to make it up. If